Yeah, I give an example of analyzing non-stationary time series. So the example that I want to discuss here is the so-called tent map time series. So the idea is that you have an iterative map that maps the range from 0 to 1 onto the range from 0 to 1 by means of this black function. So you start with an arbitrary value between 0 and 1, let's say the wi here. Then you look at the function value that gives you the next wi plus 1. And then you feed this value back. Let's say it's here. That gives you wi plus 2 and so on, right? So you feed this through the same function over and over again. That gives a time series that looks like this. And the tent map is known to generate a notoriously sort of noisy time series. So from just looking at this, you would not expect that it has been generated in such a systematic fashion. Now, what complicates matter here now is that that we shift our tent map back and forth by a parameter gamma dash, so that if the tent map is shifted in a cyclic fashion, and you feed in the same value, you get a different value here, wi plus 1, this red one instead of this black one. So in the course of this time series, the tent maps get shifted left and right. However, it is not known to the system how this is shifted. It's not even known how this time series has been generated. And the question is, can we extract this so-called driving force, so the slowly varying underlying parameter is called driving force. Can we extract the driving force directly from this time series without knowing anything about the mapping and the characteristics of the driving force? In order to apply slow feature analysis to this, we have to do time embedding. I mean, this is a one-dimensional signal. There's only one component, and there's not much one could extract from that. But what we do is we sort of take a few successive time points and glue them together in a vector, and feed that into the system. Maybe I can visualize this. Okay, so if we have few data points, right, a time series somehow. So this is a one-dimensional time series, and we can create a three-dimensional time series, let's say. So for the first time point, I take these three vectors, these three values. For the second time point, I take these three values. For the third, I take these three vectors, etc. Yeah, so all these three successive time points make up a three-dimensional input vector. Get the idea. That's called time embedding, right? So that's a way to create a three-dimensional time series from a one-dimensional time series. Here you see the time series, and here you see the driving force. So that's the change that we apply, that's the shift that we apply to the tent map. And now, if we do this time embedding and we apply slow feature analysis to this, and then we actually extract these points, right? I mean, this dashed line or these pointy lines is what SFA extracts, and the solid line is the true driving force. And the embedding that we have done is we have used 10 successive time points here, and we have used cubic SFA, so polynomials of degree 3. I should mention that, I mean, we know that slow feature analysis extracts signals that have zero mean and unit variance, and you your driving force is maybe not normalized in such a way. So what you need to do in order to compare these two is you have to rescale the axis. So the true driving force lies somewhere between -1 and +1, while the estimated driving force lies somewhere between -2 and +2. Both have roughly zero mean, but you need to do this rescaling, of course, because the variance cannot be estimated by SFA. But you see a pretty good fit between the estimated driving force and the true driving force. And this is done without knowing anything about the tent map and without knowing anything about the character of the driving force. In fact, you can also have driving forces that switch discretely between certain values, and SFA would also extract that.